welcome to another video in the Scriptcase macros course. So today we're looking at the SE confirm macro. So my name is Nate Carpenter and I'm the Scriptcase instructor leading this course. So let's get started with SE confirm and see what it does. So SE confirm displays a JavaScript confirmation dialog. So you might have seen these before. This is just an easy way to do it in Scriptcase. So let's go ahead and look at the documentation for this. So let me get out of this and go over to the Scriptcase macro documentation. Here we are. And let's scroll down to the control section. So down here, and let me go ahead and find SE confirm. And there it is. Let me click on that. So SE confirm, here's the documentation for it. Here's where it can be used. Tells a little bit of what it does. And it needs to be called through like a button in a toolbar button or something like that. Let's go ahead and copy this example right here. So this is set up and easy to use. Let's go ahead and go over to the Scriptcase development environment. So here's a form I have set up. Let me run it and show it to you. Just a basic form, nothing too special about this. But we're going to go ahead and add a button up here to do this. So we're going to go to buttons, new button right here on the left. And it needs to be a PHP button. And I'm going to call this reset. So name it and then click create. So we have some different options here, but what we really need to do is edit this PHP code section. This is the on click of the button. So let me get rid of the extra question mark here, but this should be ready to work now. So when we click this button, we'll get a confirmation dialog. And this is in the Sweet Alert 2 system. So it's going to look a little bit nicer than a standard JavaScript alert. So there's our reset button. We can move it around, but let's go ahead and click it. And there is our dialog. Do you really wish to execute this action? We can click cancel or we can click OK. And it's going to go through and give us this OK dialog, where it executes the logic that we put in there. So let's put some logic in there. So after this confirmation dialog, we can then put some logic to be executed that will only be executed if they click yes. So let's go ahead and let's cancel out some fields. So we're going to reset the first name and the last name field. So we're going to put it in the curly braces like so. Let me make sure it's formatted correctly. So first underscore name, that is the field name of the first name field, as you can see on the left. Just going to set it equal to an empty text string and then do the same for last name, last underscore name. So this will be executed then if the user clicks OK as opposed to cancel. So let me run this. It should work now. So if we click reset here, and then if we click cancel here, nothing would happen. So let me do that. As you can see, nothing happens again. And then we click OK, and it's going to reset. So it goes through to the OK dialog and resets just as we would expect. So that's how you use the SE confirm macro to pop up a confirmation dialog for your users.